Well, based upon recent studies during the pandemic, more women than men put off their normal well woman appointments. They delayed important life-changing screening exams. Dr. Rachel Haley from HCA Midwest Health discusses these consequences and shares how you can jumpstart your health care.
Dr. Haley, it didn't take long for us to go out with the old routines as we put our lives on hold during the pandemic, including preventative and well woman checks. Why are those so important to a woman's future health?
So many of my female patients tell me that while they did stop routine health exams in 2020, they jumped right into caring for their families when the coronavirus hit. So now that the world is reopening and physicians are seeing patients in person, people are starting to understand that scheduling those preventative screening visits are so important. It's time to say, okay, time to focus on myself and my health. No doubt you've heard that physicians are particularly concerned about women delaying mammograms. Experts predict that the number of people who will die from breast or colorectal cancer in the U.S. will rise by almost 10,000 over the next decade because of COVID-19's disruption of screenings and treatments. As a family care physician, I can't help but worry when patients don't come in for their annual well woman exams.
What about the annual physical? Is it really that critical, especially if you're healthy?
The once a year checkup is an opportunity for your healthcare provider to look for common chronic diseases like high blood pressure and diabetes, which can be asymptomatic for a long time. Regular contact with your primary care provider is extremely important. Routine blood tests and screenings can offer important clues about your health and catch problems early when they're usually easier to treat.
Does the well woman exam fall into the preventative care category, Dr. Haley?
Although women no longer need a pap test and a pelvic exam every year, unless your doctor recommends them, it is still highly recommended to see your gynecologist yearly to talk about your overall health, the big picture. A woman's gynecologist is often seen as her primary care physician, and they deliver comprehensive head-to-toe care. A well woman visit covers everything from breast health and reproductive issues to healthy lifestyle counseling and heart health too, since heart disease is the leading cause of death in women. It's also a good time to check in on something that we all need to be aware of coming out of the pandemic: screening for anxiety, depression, and increased alcohol use.
What routine tests do you recommend for women in their 20s and 30s?
This is a good time to start getting your cholesterol levels checked and discussing cervical cancer screening. There are vaccinations that may be due. Now is also the time to talk with your healthcare provider if you are thinking about having children. Skin checks are important as well. Self-exams are encouraged, but prevention is the best medicine. Invest in your future with sun protective measures and routine checkups.
I've read that your 30s and 40s are times to be concerned about blood pressure and other screenings, especially if you've had a family history or other personal risk factors.
So important, even in your 30s, to start keeping an eye out for things like hypertension, especially if it runs in your family. Your 40s are a time to really keep track of your blood pressure, consider screening for diabetes, and discuss breast and colon cancer screenings. I also like to talk to patients about perimenopause, that period that leads up to menopause and can last 4 to 10 years and comes with a variety of symptoms that can affect mood, sleep, and libido.
For women in their 50s and 60s, what do they need to keep at the top of their health?
Regular mammography and colon cancer screenings are recommended. This is also the time for women to consider their bone health. As estrogen drops after menopause, bones start to lose their density, which can make them easier to break from simple missteps or falls. So it's important to get adequate vitamin D to absorb calcium better and engage in weight-bearing exercise to promote bone health. Women in their 50s and 60s should discuss when to get a bone density to evaluate for osteoporosis based on their risk factors. In your 60s and older, pay attention to neurocognitive aging. Tell your physician right away about any troubling issues like forgetfulness or not being able to think clearly. The bottom line is the best way to invest in your future health today is to get connected with your healthcare provider, regardless of your age. It's time to put yourself first, and you're worth it.
Invest in your future health today. Schedule your preventative care, screenings, and exams. Visit hcamidwest.com.